What is up, my fellow gamers? In today's video, we got our best beginner's guide and codes for the official global launch of Isekai Feast Tales of Recipe. Like and sub for more amazing gaming content. Let's go over our coupon codes first. We got a boatload of them. We're gonna head on over to our avatar top left corner, and we're gonna go to redeem. First code, IFTOR, confirm. What? We got some good rewards on that one. Next one is gonna be recipes, RECIPES, confirm. Some more awesome rewards. We also got a bubble storyline as well. Next one is gonna be tales, TALES, confirm. This is going to give us our avatar frame storybook. Next one is going to be Isekai, I-S-E-K-A-I, confirm. This is going to give us a 10 draw. Next one's going to be Feast, F-E-A-S-T, confirm. This is going to give us some diamonds and some more free rewards. And the final one is going to be VIP-777, confirm. And we get ourselves a 5. Star fire character. Now that's not just it, there is also some extra coupon codes that you can kind of get. It's going to be on the website. Let me show you how to do that as well. All right, we're on the official website. I'll leave a link down below in the description box so you can navigate to it. Once you get here, you're just going to scroll down a little bit, and we have some different gift packs. We got a welcome pack, another pack, I don't know how to say that, and we also got a blessing pack. All you're going to do is click claim now, then you're going to take your phone and you're going to scan that QR code, and you need to do this through the specific app though, so not like the game. There is the dev company has their own specific app that gives you these special rewards through the games. It wouldn't work on my phone. Maybe it'll work on yours. So I'm just throwing it out there. All right, now let's go into some beginner tips to help you out. The first thing that I noticed is there is a bajillion different ways for you to spend your diamonds. And there's a lot of like secret hidden areas to go through to get like bonus advanced summoning tickets at a cheaper price. We go on over to the town and we go to the summoning temple. This is where we can go ahead and do a bunch of different summons, normal summons. We have this other summon. We also have the advanced summon. Do not waste your diamonds doing any of these summons. It's definitely not worth it, especially for the elite recruitment. If we head on over in that top corner right there, this one, we can choose one of these characters to increase the probability. Don't waste 2,000 diamonds on this. It's not worth it. Tons of other ways to spend your diamonds. You can also just get these elite scrolls and use them, which I recommend instead of just wasting diamonds. But while we're here, we're gonna go over to the top right where it says summon list. Then we're gonna go to where it says gift pack. And then here you can go ahead and you can spend 1,000 diamonds to get some of these summoning tickets, specifically a 10 pull for 1,000. And if you don't do it this way and you just spend your diamonds, it's gonna cost you 2,000 diamonds. It's a complete ripoff. So there's a lot of little hidden areas in this game where you can use diamonds to buy tickets for a lot cheaper than just going in there and straight up spending the diamonds in the gacha. So just be on the lookout for that. The other one is the Lucky Store. The Lucky Store, you can see like right here, we can get 7% off. We can get 10 tickets for 1,000. You can also refresh this as well. We can also head into the Mystic Store, and this is gonna have some good offers occasionally for you to look out. So you can see we got our summoning tickets. These are 160 though. So buying 10 of these is gonna end up being 1,600, which is still cheaper than the 2,000, but it's definitely not a good deal. So look for the discounts. As you play the game, you're gonna get this option 10X. Choose 1 out of 4 guaranteed 5-star heroes. Now all of these heroes, they're all predetermined. So it kind of does like a gacha roll and it makes you think it's random, but it's not random. Everyone has the same 4 options. There's gonna be one specific one that I'm gonna recommend you take. And that is gonna be this girl right here, the fire chick, Elisa. Really strong AoE damage dealing mage. The other ones are okay, they're not like great. I actually already pulled Robert just from a regular 10 pull, and he's pretty decent, he's not like bad. The other thing that you also have to keep in mind is for your team building, you wanna try and build out a mono solid team of just one color, specifically one element, because you're gonna get bonuses depending on how many characters of the same element you have in your lineup. In this top area right next to my name, if we click the little wheel, we can see the rock, paper, scissors attribute thing where one element counters the other. But we also have our active stat total bonuses down here, and you can see Once we have like five of the same type of heroes, like five flame heroes, we're getting an extra 20% HP and an extra 17% attack. As far as I know, the bonuses that you get for the different elements, it's for your entire lineup. It's not just for those specific elements. So like if we have three flame heroes, everyone in our lineup is getting that extra 12% and that extra 9%. So like this is our total bonus right now. So even if you go with like three flame characters right here and then also three earth characters, you'll see that they're combining both of them. So we're getting 24% for our HP because our HP is 12% for the earth and then 12% for the flame. And then we're getting 18% for our attack. This is another option you can do, or you could go 2, 2, and 2, which would be pretty close to the same if you have 2 fire, 2 earth, 2 water. As far as who to choose for your elite probability up, we have a couple different options. Again, it's really gonna depend on what element you are trying to build out. I'm gonna be going for like more of a fire team. So I'm gonna be choosing a fire element to kind of supplement them. But for most new players, your best bet is going to be the Blizzard guy, this one right here, as well as the Soul Spring Natasha. Pretty much either of these two water ones, they're really, really strong. Also, early on as a new player, don't be afraid to just upgrade all of the characters that you have that are kind of crappy because you have the ability to do rebirth and just rebirth them and you'll get everything back. You can do it 8 times a day. The game's very free to play friendly in the aspect of experimenting with different builds, experimenting with different teams. So if you got a lot of fire characters, just build an all fire mono team right now. And then if you go ahead and you start pulling better water characters or nature characters, then just rebirth all your fire and then invest in all of the better nature characters or earth or whatever you get. So it's a lot of kind of building up a team and then breaking it down and then investing in another team. That's gonna be your main goal. That's gonna help you advance the fastest in this game. The difference between the SRs and the SSRs is going to be the abilities that they have. You can rank up an SR unit to 5 stars, 6 stars, so on and so forth. But the SR units are only gonna have 3 abilities. And you're gonna get that 3rd ability once you get them to level 50. So any epics, try and immediately get them to 50, all 3 of their skills unlocked and usable during battles. And the SSR units, like this one right here, you're gonna have 4 different abilities. And once you get them to level 80, then you will unlock their 4th skill. And then you can really experiment with them and see how all 4 of their skills work in battle. As far as the relics go, it's gonna be dependent on which kind of content you're doing. Even though the Scorch Gaze is like the first relic you unlock, it's still really good in certain situations. So the main thing you're looking at is the burn effect. The enemy's gonna lose 5% max HP per turn for 2 turns. This is gonna be amazing anytime you're doing boss battles. Specifically, there is an advanced boss battle mode. Then the next one's gonna be the Sacred Prayer. This is really good for PvP content. Decreases the target's attack by 10%. You're going up against someone who's stronger than you, has higher power. Sometimes this can kind of mitigate that power difference and you can still win. The Life Cradle goes ahead and it restores a bunch of HP to your characters. So it's basically a heal. This is good for PvE content, pretty much almost any content in general. Ideally though, the Lost Melody, this one's gonna be the best for PvP because it gives you a chance to inflict a stun and it bypasses that control resistance as well, and it goes to 2 targets. That is it. I hope you guys and girls enjoyed the video. Stay happy, stay safe. I'll see y'all later. Peace.